Welcome back, True Believers and all you spectacular Spidey fans, to another very exciting episode of Marvel Spider-Man 2 101, where we are once again going to be diving into the entirety of the recently released story trailer, but this time we are going to be analyzing it from the perspectives of the developers themselves. Where if you are following along with all the news that came out of the San Diego Comic-Con 2023 Hall H panel, alongside of PlayStation uploading the entirety of the Hall H panel online for anyone to view, they went on to post a PlayStation blog, which not only broke down even more details about what was included in the story trailer, but we went on to receive even further information about the game from the developers themselves, which completely discussed in detail even further information relating to the gameplay, the story, and of course Venom himself, which once again may or may not tease the possibility of Venom being a fully playable character in Marvel's Spider-Man 2. So if you're excited to learn about all this information, then definitely be sure to thwip that like button and subscribe to the channel for any major Marvel Spider-Man 2 news and updates. So as this first statement from the PlayStation blog does come from the Marvel Spider-Man 2 senior narrative director of John Paquette, he goes on to say that at the beginning of our story, our Spider-Men are at the top of their game, but both Peter Parker and Miles Morales are struggling with their personal lives. Miles is trying to find time to write his college entrance essay, but he keeps procrastinating and focusing on spider work instead. Meanwhile, Peter is underwater on payments for Aunt May's house, but he can't sell it because it means too much to him. And just like Miles, Peter tries and fails to find balance with so many responsibilities. MJ wants to help Pete with the mortgage, but her job is on the line now that J. Jonah Jameson is back at the Bugle and looking to clean house. Our heroes have arrived at a confluence of crossroads, with uncertain futures and some tough decisions ahead. And now, when Kraven's hunters arrive in the city, it sets off a mystery of why they are there and who and what they are hunting. But as the Spider-Man and MJ dig deeper into Kraven's motivations, the symbiote begins to threaten Marvel's New York and everyone and everything they hold dear. And just like Insomniac have already done with the previous Spider-Man game stories, they are going to be telling a very personal narrative to both Peter Parker and Miles Morales' lives both in and out of the mask, which as we all know as diehard Spider-Man fans is exactly what we want to expect when it comes to a AAA Spider-Man story. The story trailer that we got from Comic-Con already did a great job of teasing what we can expect from Peter and Miles' personal stories, and as a gamer, it's making me even more excited to see exactly how Insomniac have improved Peter and Miles' gameplay outside of them being Spider-Man. But as for whether or not we still might end up seeing that quick change alleyway mechanic is still unknown. But as for that particular gameplay idea, that's just gonna remain on my personal wish list for now. And speaking of gameplay, this is where the article goes on to state that as many of you noticed in the Marvel Spider-Man 2 gameplay trailer from the PlayStation Showcase in May, Peter's new black suit affected his personality and gives him new, powerful symbiote abilities. You see bits of that in this trailer as well, and you can see Peter's symbiote powers tax his relationships with Miles, MJ, and Harry, which I find very interesting, even though we were already aware that the black suit was going to impact Peter's relationships with Mary Jane and Miles Morales, but now we also know that Harry is going to be impacted by the black suit as well, which may or may not lead to his inevitable turn as Venom. But as for who exactly Venom's host is going to be is still a mystery, and we likely won't find out for sure until the game fully releases on October 20th. Now, moving right along into a bit of a spoiler territory is that the article goes on to say spoilers for 2018's Marvel Spider-Man. Given how much Miles Morales looks up to Peter for mentorship and guidance, this creates further problems. Beyond trying to figure out what's next for his life, Miles continues to struggle with the death of his father at the hands of Martin Lee, aka Mr. Negative. And as you saw from the trailer, you haven't seen the last of Mr. Negative. And this was hands down one of the most shocking reveals throughout the entirety of the story trailer. Not only is it fantastic to see the phenomenal Steven O'Young reprise his role as Martin Lee within Marvel Spider-Man 2, but we're now finally going to see the narrative conclusion of Miles' arc and his relationship with Mr. Negative. And hearing Najee Jeter himself talk about this moment during the Hall H panel got me even more hyped to see this full scene in action.
Coming back to Martin Lee, man, that was something big. I didn't think that we would revisit that, because we had a lot of emotions on set.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I was raised by a single mom, so you know, I don't have my dad in my life. So that was a kind of a boom right there. So we kept it right there, but we delivered some great things for y'all.
Now, moving on more from the story elements of Marvel's Spider-Man 2 into the gameplay details, we did receive a lot of insights from both Brian Intihar and Ryan Smith about how they have evolved the Marvel Spider-Man 2 gameplay from the previous games. Whereas Brian goes on to say is that we've always thought of our spider heroes as acrobatic improvisers. And in Marvel's Spider-Man 2, we wanted to equip them with new ways to do so during combat. This includes Pete's spider arms and symbiote powers, while Miles now brings two forms of bioelectric venom to every fight. And when you start combining these abilities with all new spider gadgets like the web grabber, it can lead to some exciting combos, which we obviously already got a taste of within the gameplay demo. But as for Marvel's Spider-Man 2's new explorable areas, the PS blog describes that this trailer also provided some new looks at our expanded Marvel's New York. Now, you'll be able to swing across the East River and explore Brooklyn and Queens. Coney Island makes its debut as well in the trailer, and we can't wait for you to explore it. And one way you can explore it is with the web wings. Let's hear more from the senior game director, Ryan Smith, where Ryan goes on to say that we are really excited for people to try out the web wings. For us, it was a cool opportunity to bring something people have seen in comics and movies and integrate it in the game. And in regards to the next line of dialogue, which I find the most important from Ryan, is that he says swinging is the core of our Spider-Man traversal. So we designed the web wings to work with swinging and complement it. That way, you can weave back and forth between the two to build up speed and height. When you use the web wings with our wind tunnels, though, that's one of the ways to go across the city super fast and really push the speed of traversal, which was one of our goals. Thanks to the power and the speed of the PS5, web wings add another layer to our traversal system and change up how you look at getting around the different parts of the city. So hands down, the most important line of dialogue that I think Ryan says within this article is that the web wings are merely a complement to the already fully established web swinging system, instead of a completely different form of traversal which would simply make web swinging completely useless. I love how it sounds like that the player is really going to need to master how they want to traverse the city depending on the particular borough they're located in within Marvel's New York. And being able to mix and match things like web swinging, wall running, parkouring, and now web wings all in unison within this game's traversal system is easily making it out to be one hell of a good time. And last but not least within this PS blog, we not only went over a lot of details relating to the game's story and some brand new gameplay mechanics, but the biggest star of the show within Marvel's Spider-Man 2 as it currently stands right now is the symbiote menace himself, of Venom. Where once again coming from Brian Intihar is that our philosophy has always been that we want to respect the history of the franchise and the Spider-Man DNA, but also not be afraid to mix things up. The same holds true for one of its iconic characters, Venom. While the look of the character and several of his powers slash abilities should be familiar to fans, this will be a unique Venom story that we are excited for everyone to experience this October. And as it is highlighted by the narrative director of Marvel's Spider-Man 2, once again of John Paquette, he goes on to say that when we decided to craft a Venom story, we knew we'd be making a bit of a tone shift. The best symbiote stories serve as an allegory. We all have darkness inside of us, but what would happen if we let it take over? With the introduction of the symbiote into our franchise, our heroes are forced to battle darkness in all of its forms. We wanted to see them change, both inside and outside, and feel the effect it has on those around them. And when Venom takes control, they face the real danger that they could lose themselves and their loved ones forever. And to cap off the article once more by the art director of Marvel's Spider-Man 2 herself, of Jacinda Chu, she states that our Venom was inspired by the comics, but there have been so many interpretations that it was fun to pick and choose what fits the game. He has a unique take on the white spider icon, and has the anatomy of a human. He also has powerful tendril attacks that can take many forms. It was challenging to find the right balance between liquid and solid in Venom's materials, as going too watery makes him look weak, and going too solid can quickly turn him into a tentacle monster. Venom must look both powerful and semi-liquid at the same time. So not only do I love how much effort and detail Insomniac is incorporating within the narrative and gameplay elements of Venom's character within Marvel Spider-Man 2 as a whole, but I also find the particular wording of Venom's description very, very interesting. Mainly where they go on to say that Venom has very powerful tendril attacks, and that several of his powers and abilities should be familiar to fans. Which I'm sure Brian is referring to if any of us have read a comic featuring Venom before, but I also think there's a very good chance that they could be referencing the Ultimate Spider-Man video game, where of course Venom was a fully playable character. And he also had a lot of abilities like tendril attacks and claw swipes. Not to mention feeding on every single human being in sight.
We get to kill little children? Oh my, that's fucked up and I love it!
And yet again, even if we are able to only control Venom for a very small portion within Marvel Spider-Man 2, having the ability to actually play as Venom at some point during the game would simply be a dream come true. But alas, we're just gonna have to wait and see as to whether or not Insomniac will fully give the fans what they want. And until that time comes, everybody, that's the video I have for all you today, and please let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. What do you think of all these Marvel Spider-Man 2 details coming from Insomniac and PlayStation? And on a scale of 1 to 10, how likely do you think it is that we'll actually be able to play as Venom in Marvel Spider-Man 2? Let me know what you think, be sure to leave a like on the video, and subscribe to the channel if you did enjoy, and for more Marvel Spider-Man 2 videos like this in the future. Thank you all so much for watching, stay spectacular, Spidey fans, and until next time, peace out.